Jack Dodson? At least that boy was going somewhere. At least he
is a spoiled rich boy waiting for his trust fund to kick in.
Wait, that douchebag on the school's football team? He would have held you to higher standards. He wouldn't have stood for you dressing like this. Acting like this.
Stop.
That boy would have had enough brains.
I said stop.
To not let any of this have happened.
Except he did.
What?
He did this to me.
What the hell are you talking about?
Winter break. I was hanging out with the team a lot. Jack took me to homecoming.
And you slept with him?
No. I mean, I don't remember.
Oh, wow. How could you not remember?
We were at this party after the game.
No.
And people were drinking.
No, 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 no. You are not saying this right now. This is not happening.
I must have blacked out or something.
I really don't want to hear the rest.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry? Let me believe the baby was mine. You're sorry? How could you not tell me?
How could I tell you? How could I admit something like this to you, to anyone? I thought you would...
Leave? You thought I would leave? Yeah. Good guess.
No. Alex, please, I am so sorry.
Oh, wow, Callie. You got wasted. Slept with the biggest asshat in school, and now you're trying to justify that?
Jack is a student. Brett Dawson.
Yeah, Mr. Anderson. Jack Dodson, the high and mighty football star.
Can't believe it.
I can't. Does that idiot even know about this?
He does.
And what does Mr. Perfect have to say about getting you pregnant?
If it gets out, he'll make my life a living hell.
God, such a dick. You're a liar.
I never should have lied. I was so ashamed. God, I never should have gone to that stupid party or worn that stupid makeup or these stupid fucking clothes. You want to blame someone for this, Dad? Blame me, okay? I asked for this. You were right. I'm a whore.
Yep. I would like to set an appointment for my daughter, Callie Anderson, as soon as possible. Yes, 4 o'clock would be just fine.
Who are you talking to?
Well, the clinic. We're going to take care of this immediately.
No, wait, no. Dad? Dad, stop it. I am keeping the baby.
Like hell you are.
You seriously want to keep it?
This is on me.
Callie. I don't want you to ruin your life over one single foolish decision. You want to stay underneath this roof? This is what we're going to do. You're going to get an abortion. You're going to graduate high school. And then you're going to attend Yale like we planned. You will put this behind you.
No.
No? Young lady, you are 17!
18 in less than a month.
And then you'll magically know everything?
Maybe not. But I do know I can't take the easy way out because things got hard.
So you're telling me you're going to raise a baby as a teenager? No money, no job, no plan for the future?
No, I will graduate high school. I will apply to college. But I will do it as a mother.
Completely on your own?
Not completely.
What?
You're actually going to stand by her side. She's pregnant with someone else's child.
She made a mistake. She knows that.
Alex,
Don't! Not yet. Sir, I love her.
You love her. That means you'll sacrifice your entire life just to be with her? Give me a break.
Isn't that what you did for me? Daddy?
I don't know what you want me to say. I don't know how to be okay with this.
Neither do I.
I don't expect you to be. Either of you.
We worked so hard to get you where you're at right now. And it's like I failed you.
Failed me? This was my mistake. You're the one that made me strong enough to face it.
Always been a soldier.
I've always been just like you. Not Mom. You. And God gives his toughest battles to the strongest soldiers, right? Look, I want you to support me on this, Dad. I really, really do. If you can't, I understand. I guess what I need to know is, do I walk out that door or do I stay?
Stay. Both of you. Stay.
You want to live like us?
Huh? Watching our dad being dragged through hell? Because of criminals like you.
Your daddy bought a one-way ticket when he shot Kane.
That's so.
Chill, D. Let's just work on our signs. I don't want to get written up for him.
How can you turn on your family?
I would never do that. All I'm saying is we don't know what happened. We don't know what's going to happen. We know a kid is dead and we know dad's involved.
And if we get to choose who comes home at the end of the night, we choose him. Do you really want to see dad go to jail for the rest of his life for some kid who's breaking into houses?
Breaking into houses?
Stay out of our business.
It's not even true. Diana said—
Why do you keep defending this kid?
Diana said what? Oh, that you said my name. Speak your mind.
Oh, so now you have nothing to say? You've been sitting here bashing—
Don't you have a sign to make? Isn't that what you do?
What we do?
You know, make a sign. Retweet Black Lives Matter. Protest for Instagram likes.
You think this is a game? Making signs for this? This shit ain't fun.
Nah, cause he too stupid to think. Let's just do this before Miss L hears you cussing and I have to kill me a white boy.
That was too far. If it wasn't dad,
you
would—
It is dad. That's the point. You're white. Sympathy doesn't make you one of them.
Just work on your sign time.
I don't get why Miss L got us up in here with his kids. She talking about make a sign. We already know what they gonna say.
Did you see Caroline's face when you said, kill me a white boy?
Yeah, and?
I don't know. I just wish we could watch the news. I need to know what they're saying.
Lies? Nothing? Lies? I mean, seriously, you don't need to see pictures of it and all of that
nonsense. Pictures? Now they got pictures of him? Laying out on that street like he ate somebody's child? It's not enough that everybody in town is picking him apart.
No, okay,
all
right.
Pictures?
You're right. That's not cool. And I shouldn't have brought it up. But you should write that down.
For what? Tyler's right. How is my sign going to look any different than all the other black people out there? You know that's what they'll call it. Angry black girl makes angry sign.
That idiot doesn't know what he's talking about. And I mean, so what? You are angry. You have a right to be angry. Just make sure you print it clearly enough that they get the message.
Can't make two nothing but walk outside. It ain't illegal. Family news talk about that man like he's hurting, but Cam's gone.
Erica?
What do you want?
What's up?
May I sit with you? I don't want any trouble.
Oh, well then you should have stayed your lily white ass over there with your redneck brother.
Last week we were friends.
Are you trying to get dragged right now?
Chill, Lee. Caroline had never started drunk with us before.
That's right before. As before her daddy shot Cam.
Thank you, Diana. I needed to hear that. I don't hear it enough from everywhere else.
If you think about sitting with a girl whose family killed your cousin, then yeah, you need to hear it.
Oh, so now it's not just my dad, it's my whole family that's responsible for what happened? You're acting like I'm the one who
killed Cameron?
Chill, D. You're so busy ranting and raving, you just want to fight.
Yeah, I want to fight.
It's my cousin that died. My cousin.
Well, someone should be fighting for Cam. I mean, her daddy is the one who pulled the trigger. You're sitting here talking to her like everything's cool. Right now, it is us or them.
This isn't a war.
That is exactly what it is. And we lose this battle every day to racist-ass cops and the lily white families. And you're stupid if you think it's anything but a war. And you, fight back. We need soldiers.
Well, you better go and enlist someone else, because drama ain't going to help me or mine so bounce. And don't get it twisted. I'm not on your side either.
Okay, everyone. Your assignment was to make signs. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Blue lives matter, of course.
Your assignment was to write your feelings, not a slogan, Tyler.
These are my feelings.
You are an idiot.
Miss Laster, can we please watch the news?
Okay. Watch while you finish your assignment.
Still no statement from the Holland City Police Department. Will they indict Officer Arnold after the deadly shooting of 17-year-old Cameron Jefferson? According to Pastor Harold Langston, Cameron was an A student and an active volunteer in the community. His presence will be missed.
No formal statements yet from the Holland City Police Department. We've been informed that Cameron Jefferson was discovered vandalizing homes the night Arnold fought
as a criminal.
School records indicate that Jefferson has a history of being disruptive in class. He was suspended last year. Bringing a weapon to school.
A weapon?
Coming to you live, a statement from the victim's family. Mother Santa Jefferson and brother Clarence Jefferson.
Thank you both so much for being here. I realize what a hard time this must be for you. Who would like to speak first?
Most of you already decided who my brother was, what him dying means to you. Started making signs, lacing up shoes to come here, say something. Before I even knew, he was gone. Crazy, cause we twins. I should have felt it. You act like you got answers, I don't. We twins. My whole life I knew what that meant. What does it mean now? My brother's dead. Who am I now?
I'm tired. My family is tired. A man called my house last night talking about his condolences, telling me he stands for Black Lives Matter. That ain't my child's name. His name is Cameron. His name was Cameron Anthony Jefferson. Look at all of you standing around here putting on a show. Half of you don't even know my child's name. You're just circling around our heads like vultures. You gonna help me box his clothes? You gonna go with us to the mailbox when his college letters come and he ain't there to open them? Where you gonna be once you pick my child's bones clean? People keep asking me what they can say, what they can do. You can remember him. You can say his name and just remember him. People stare at me, thinking of something to say. Nothing. Ain't a single thing you can say to me. My child ain't dead and spared from disease. He just gone. There's no comfort here.
Thank you. I'm sorry for your loss. Back to you, Tom.
He carries weapons to school.
The law is the law. The guy wasn't an angel. He was breaking into houses.
Tyler, that's enough. Let's go ahead and read our signs.
Bye. I'll go first. The guy's name was Cameron. My black
is not a choice. Your hate is. Why is it always about race with you people? The law is the law. Get over it.
The law is the law. Bullets aren't the law. They just put you in your place.
Exactly.
You're preaching to the wrong crowd. It comes with the territory. Guns and the law are one and the same. My sign isn't changing.
Yes, and that's shocking to hear. And you can think more about that while you're suspended. Erica, what about yours?
Remember us for who we are. We are more than the pictures of what hate does to us. That's beautiful. I wasn't sure what to say. The man people hate right now is the man who hugs me when I get home from school every day. It seems to me when I'm scared. Right now, I'm scared. It's my dad. I don't want him to live with this. My family is living with it. Cameron's mom said this, and I get it.
There's no comfort here.
There's no comfort for your family or mine, Erica. Bullets break things. Bodies, bones, families.
A statement has been released. The DA will indict Officer Joseph Arnold for the lethal shooting of Cameron Jefferson.
Officer Arnold will be indicted for the shooting of Cameron Jefferson. A date will be set for trial. Let's hope this gives comfort to his family. This is Jeff Brighton, Channel 7 News.
Reacting,
we're
American,
I can do it. American, I can do it.
that wall faster.
Yeah, the sooner the better. Then we won't have to deal with so many illegals in this country. So do you think you'll win?
Haven't lost yet.
I am so glad you're running again this year.
Had to. Couldn't let my school be run by some immigrant.
This is low, Cassie, even for you.
Oh, sick loser.
What's wrong? Don't you like my artwork?
Oh yeah, you're a real Annie Leibovitz.
Who?
Seriously?
The one who takes pictures of celebrities as Disney princesses? What do you want, Mexico?
I'm Puerto Rican, and I want you to take down these posters you plastered all over the school.
No can do. Ethan worked really hard on these.
Yeah, I could even win a Darwin Award or something.
I think you mean a Nobel Prize.
Whatever the prize, my baby can win it. He can win anything.
These posters need to come down.
Or what?
Or I'll tell Principal Thatcher and you'll be out of the race.
You don't have the guts, Chipotle!
Or the proof.
Yeah, it's not like old hatchet face would believe a single word you say.
Cass, what the hell?
Stop, loser.
Can't drone adult conversation.
You and dear sister are far from adult.
And these posters prove you are.
I thought Mom and Dad taught you better. Please! Dad practically cheered me on when I showed it to him.
And what did Mom say?
She's got her nose buried so far in her Bible, she hardly notices anything.
That's because she thinks you're the spawn of Satan.
Jojo, don't. She's your sister.
So? That doesn't excuse her?
Look who's spicier than you.
Shut up, Ethan, or I'll cut off your balls.
Jojo, enough!
No! Let her stand up for herself.
Excuse me?
What? You can't speak English anymore?
Stacy, I swear to God you're asking.
About time you grew a spine.
Yo, Bruno, Bruno!
Oh! Maybe now you can finally join the ranks.
Babe, we're not in the army.
Why would I want to join you?
Hey, joining us is an honor.
Yeah, you should be grateful. Cassie actually wants to accept you.
Accept me? Accept me? I'm her sister, you have
it! Hey, don't touch my boyfriend like that.
Oh? What are you gonna do about it?
Push me, freak show!
Bring it, Mama.
So about to put you stupid bitch!
Jump down!
Slow your rolls! Jeez, what's gotten into you?
These posters are what's gotten into me! I'm so tired of you picking on Selena! You photoshopped her head on a mule! That's barbaric!
Barbaric? That's politics.
This is not politics. Politics would be a debate on how to actually make our school better.
But that's easy. No more Mexicans.
I'm Puerto Rican and I wasn't talking to you.
Cassie doesn't know the first thing about politics. What I know is that I was elected student body president for freshman year, sophomore year, and junior year.
That still amazes me.
Cass, I think you have to dumb it down for her.
Don't stoop to her level.
Let me explain it to you this way. Do you know how anyone becomes president?
Yep. Cheated.
Wrong! They're popular, and so am I! It's how I've won every year.
That's what's wrong with our system. It's why I finally decided to run against you. Unlike you, I actually stand for something other than myself.
Let your voice be heard. Let's stop the bullies. Vote for Selena. You can't stand up for yourself if you're an illegal.
She's foreign U.S. territory, you little minion.
You nice little sissy, just did it.
Teasing like how you teased Sarah Baxter?
What about it?
She's in the hospital because of you.
I heard it was Tony Bradshaw knocked her up.
She's on suicide watch, moron.
Whatever, suicide, she's desperate for that for you. It's not our fault.
It's your fault putting up this kind of shit all over the school.
It's how we beat out the weaklings.
Weaklings?
Yeah, they toughen kids up.
You know, sticks and stones and all that.
What are you talking about?
You know, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me.
What?
How would she know that? She's not an American.
Bullshit! Works on you!
Oh, so you're telling me every time you and your little robot tease me and ridicule me was
because it would toughen you up, and it has.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Dumb or not is how I run my school.
This isn't your school.
It might as well be with the way she runs things.
Yeah, the teachers are too dumb to notice anyway.
Texting the mothership again?
Mind your business, Stacy!
Who's Jose?
Probably the one who's going to knock her up.
Ew, you two would make ugly babies.
shop something real quick.
Okay. Waist up, I think. Make the girls nice and round.
And then we can send it to the whole school.
That's it. Hey! Do not touch my sister, immigrant.
Are you deaf? I'm Puerto Rican and I was trying to help.
Ooh, Mexico City, bounce up spice.
Puerto Rican, do I need to dumb it down for you? P-U-E-R-T-O-R-I-C-A-N.
Don't stoop to her level.
You're right. At least I don't have to sleep my way to the top.
At least I can get some.
What can you get?
A taco.
Good one, babe.
Yeah, good one, Ethan. Like when you tease Maria?
My sister was too good for you guys.
Shut up. Now is not the time.
Oh, it's the perfect time.
Don't waste your breath on them.
No, Maria was my best friend, and no one seems to want to talk about it.
There are just some things we do not talk about.
Wow, there's actually something you won't bring up.
Why is that, Cassie?
Because we just don't.
I was asking Cassie, is it because it's your fault she's dead? Or that Sarah Baxter is on suicide watch?
Again, suicides are just a desperate cry for attention.
I got a whole cry for attention? Teen suicide is a third leading cause of death because of bullying. I've caught 4,000 deaths per year. My sister was one of them. She was an actual person, now she's just a statistic.
Whatever. Not my fault she died.
It was all your fault. You guys would have stopped teasing her.
So?
She killed herself because of you. No matter what my parents did to get her out of depression, it was pointless. It was her birthday.
You made her feel worthless.
Some people can't take a joke.
To you, everything's a joke.
It's her defense mechanism.
Hey, watch it, trash bag.
Make me parasite.
Stop it! Josie Bird.
No, don't Josie Bird me. Selena's right. This is all on you. All the nights I cried myself to sleep. Maria's dead. It's all your fault. You know, I used to look up to you. Now, I can hardly stand to see your face. I'm done.
Josie Bird.
New Zealand? No, it was Australia.
Busy doing
What? I can't tell her I have no desire in going out and like staying in. That would make me look like a Ross. I'm not a Ross. I'm a Chandler. I was on a date with Babe. For you old folks, Babe, B-A-E, is an acronym short for before anyone else.
Liar, you don't have a boyfriend?
No, I do.
Who is he?
You don't know him.
And neither do you, you lying bitch.
I'm serious. He goes to school with my brother at FSCJ.
Ah. I gotta meet this guy. What's his name?
Who? My brother.
He's darling.
You'll eventually come up with a name.
What I'm about to say to her next, I am not proud of, like, at all. Okay. Have you guys ever watched the Brady Bunch? Of course you haven't. You're too busy watching fake people pretend to be real on VH1 and trying to keep up with the Kardashians. Well, there's an episode where Jan, the awkward middle child, makes up a boyfriend to ease the constant nagging of her older sister. What was her name?
Marsha.
Marsha stole the heart of the boy that Jan loves. Jan names her imaginary boyfriend George Glass. Well, I'm no kind of girl who cheats word for word, so I say this. His name is Nate Flick.
Nate Flick? What kind of a name is Nate Flick?
He's pretty hot. This weekend, we went to go see Doctor Strange.
Doctor Strange?
Yeah, at the town center. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, Tinseltown. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we went to the town center. Mm-hmm. He brought me this bracelet. Isn't it cute?
Woo! What's his Snapchat?
I have got to see what he posted about this day on his Snapchat story.
He doesn't have a Snapchat.
What about Instagram?
No Instagram.
What about Twitter?
I bet he did a live feed of the date on Twitter.
Nope, no Twitter.
Facebook?
Nope.
Kick?
Nope.
So you are telling me you are dating someone completely off the social radar, a loser. In college with a weird ass name.
Tickets on Wednesday.
I'm not going.
What do you mean? You
the location.
Location? Okay. A. Screw you. My Snapchats are works of art. And B, you need to overdose on some chill pills because it is too early in the morning for this!
Everything okay?
She'll be there. Correction, they'll be there.
They?
I'm sorry. Who said it was okay for you to copy and paste yourself into this conversation?
Oh, where are those?
Who's they?
Maya and her college boyfriend, Nate.
You have a boyfriend?
Why is that such a big freaking shock?
She never posted anything.
Here's a strange concept. Maybe, I don't know, she wanted to keep things private?
Ever thought of that?
Lauren Anderson is like Satan in human form. Her breath is always hot enough to burn your eyebrows, and she's evil. I will not let my best friend's wreck get dragged in the mud by some demon who can't even dress. No, not today, Satan.
Whatever. I guess I'll see you and your boo on Friday.
Cher Horowitz called. She wants you to keep her slowness out your freaking mouth.
You all know Cher Horowitz, right? She's a popular ballet girl. She's in that 1995 film Clueless. You all saw Clueless, right? I think it's based on like a Shakespeare play or something.
God, I hate that girl.
God hates her too.
And for some odd reason, she thinks because she's cool with Garrett, that automatically makes us friends.
We're not her friends. We're not birds of a feather.
You don't stop to get up.
Shut up. Chill. I'm going on a breakfast run. Want anything?
Nope, I'm good.
This Burger King finna be so good.
Hey, Charles. What say me and you ditch this joint and ruffle up a few papers in the teacher's lounge?
Gee, ditch class and walk right into the lion's den and get caught? What a date!
Why are we taking these?
We're going to pass them out. Maya's going to need every single vote if she wants to win. Vote for Maya.
Maya's awesome. That's what I vote for Maya.
Maya. It's always about Maya. She cock-blocks me when she didn't have a boyfriend, and now when she does.
I can't believe Maya has a hot college boyfriend.
So, she's dating a pervert?
Maya, never! She's no Kylie Jenner mother about class!
But no ass!
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm hanging on my posters, duh.
Over Maya's?
Maya didn't tell us one thing about her boyfriend. That is not something a prom queen would do.
Hey, calm down, Hillary. I got a plan. All you gotta do is ask Levi after school if he knows anyone who goes to FSCJ named Nick. I mean, he's in early college. He should know people.
I am not going to wait all day just to ask him. I need answers right now. I will take this to Twitter. All right, here we go. Maya finally has a boyfriend, and he's an older man. Hashtag TKin, hashtag cradle robber, hashtag who the hell is Nate Flex? I should get answers in no time.
Oh, no, not you two freaks.
Ah! Did you hear about Maya's new boyfriend?
Maya has a boyfriend?
His name is Nate Flix, and he goes to FSCJ.
What?
Yeah, that's Maya's boyfriend. Do you know him?
What kind of a name is Nate Flix? Wait, why does that name sound kind of familiar? Not Nate Flix? Nate Flix?
What's that? No! Her bae is Oh, this steaming hot tea deserves to be shared? I am definitely winning prom queen now.
I can't believe she lied to us like that. The day I finally work up the courage to ask her out is the day she makes up a fake boyfriend so she can be forever alone in peace? God, my life sucks!
What am I going to do? I don't know anyone that goes to FSCJ.
I go to FSCJ.
Plus my brother, who's a bigger hermit than I am, doesn't have any friends hot enough to pretend to be naked.
She could just date me.
If I miss this idiotic rap thing to binge watch Friends again, Chelsea would never let me live it down. And Lauren was loud about it to everyone. I'm so screwed!
She could just dump her lame friends and date me instead. Problem solved!
Hey, maybe one of you can help me. Are there any hot college guys out there? Anyone single and ready to mingle?
You've got to be kidding me.
Levi, shouldn't you be in someone's college algebra class right now?
What? I can't stop by to see how my favorite prisoner is holding up?
I'm doing fine. Hey, are you going to Elliot's Abilene's party?
Nope. This really isn't my thing.
How'd he take it?
He said, okay, cool, and walked off.
That's it.
Is there supposed to be more?
I told him I didn't want to go. Gave me hell for it.
That's because you lied and pulled a George Glass instead of just being honest.
I didn't pull a George Glass! Night is real!
What the heck is she doing? Why are you bothering that guy?
Come on,
Maya. Oh, long dark brown hair. Yeah, I see how it is.
Israel!
Where did you and Nate meet?
Out of play! Oh, I'm too good.
A play. Well, I guess if she's gonna lie, might as well go big or go home, right?
You don't know what you're talking about.
Maybe I don't know what I'm talking about, but I do know that he is named after a movie streaming site.
You're named after a brand of jeans, so...
Ah, touche!
Wow, that college education is really paying off.
Look at him. He was in fancy words.
Yeah, and all the times we watched Gone Girl together is really paying off, too. Look at her, making up fake boyfriends and playing down her intelligence for people who just don't deserve her.
Amy would be so proud of me.
But are you proud of yourself? Are you proud that you're going to prom just because Chelsea told you to? Are you happy you spent the entire day making up a guy who doesn't exist instead of just being honest with your friends? Yeah, I didn't think so either. Maybe you need to make better friends.
Look, you deserve a real girlfriend. You deserve someone who wouldn't interrupt a player watching. Who could land you in jail?
Guys, this is Nate.
He's Nate?
Yes! Nate! My boyfriend!
Saved by the bell.
So, he's real? I could have sworn you made up a fake boyfriend.
What is she talking about? Fake boyfriend?
Mm-hmm. I don't know! Obviously, Nate is real! He's standing right here!
hear this.
I spent 5 days all week with you guys. From 7 a.m. to 2 p.m. From 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock. We stay after school. We do homework. Play sports. Then, from 6 p.m. to 11 p.m., I'm on the phone texting all of you. Then, it starts all over again. You think with how much we talk and see each other, you want a break. But you don't! Just explore it once.
I
wanted some alone time.
You spent the entire weekend with your friends instead of hanging out with your real friends?
We're always texting.
We're friends. We're supposed to text each other all the time.
Yeah, that's like the purpose of social media. To keep us in the loop, yeah?
That's not the purpose of social media! The purpose of social media is to give old friends and relatives the illusion that your life is going great, even though it isn't. And the illusion that you guys are close, even though they really aren't. You guys are never out of the loop because you tell each other everything.
That is what best friends are supposed to do. We're supposed to tell each other everything.
But do you have to tell them everything all of the time?
Yeah. Don't want to hang out with us. Then don't.
I'm not.
She's not saying she doesn't want to hang out with you, Kevin. She just doesn't want to spend every waking moment talking and reading your idiotic posts about your mundane lives.
Mundane lives? Okay, Levi, you hate everyone. To you, everyone is a creep, an idiot, or a poser. Why do you suddenly care about what we have to say?
Because you don't deserve Maya.
Levi, stop!
No, I'm serious. None of you deserve to have Maya as a friend. None of you.
What are you doing?
I'm sticking up for you. Well, I'm doing it anyway, because that's what real friends do.
So you even know this guy?
Do I know you? Say it.
Yes.
I will kill you! So,
Lauren will be prom queen now.
What's an illusion?
Let's go!
Just the watermelon.
Stop encouraging her.
Either I encourage her or get offended. Getting offended is a lot less fun. Besides.
Fried chicken and watermelon?
Shit!
That was damn the chicken though, admit it.
Admit it!
Yes, it was delicious, but Rach, at this rate, you'll be the reason that she never changes. The reason she never realizes she has to change.
Some people don't change, babe. Some people just don't.
That doesn't excuse her ignorance.
No. We can talk about this at home. I don't want to start anything here with holy watermelon.
God's sake!
The Lord's name, Shay!
Goodness sake, Mom.
Here, Mama, let me help you.
Thank you.
Watermelon, what did you buy?
How many people did you think were coming over tonight?
Shush! Isn't it wonderful? They were 3 for 1 at the Fresh Market last night.
So you bought 9?
3.
Well, I think it's fantastic. Your mom saved money and we get to eat watermelon.
It's a win-win.
Kiss up.
Killjoy.
Good grief, there's just so much of it.
Well, that's the best thing about this. You get to take the rest of it home.
Oh, no. Oh, no, we really didn't.
Oh, nonsense. I bought it just for you, Rachel, honey. Take the watermelon home. I insist.
Is it even right?
Sean. I'd love to take the rest home. That was so thoughtful of you.
Listen, Shay. You can criticize and you can make assumptions of the quality of the fruit. But you won't know for sure until you try a piece, now can you?
What about the man you reported last night while you were buying it?
Sean!
Didn't you make assumptions about him?
Oh, don't bring us back to that topic.
You reported
him. I simply informed the policeman that his presence was a touch unnerving.
His sweatshirt made you nervous.
Not the sweatshirt, Shay. The hoodie.
So what if you saw me wearing a hoodie in 30 degree weather? Would you report me too?
They probably let him go if he turned out to be innocent. We don't need to.
And it wouldn't be the first time she's turned out to be wrong about this sort of thing.
What kind of thing?
Laisha?
Sean, you said she
this is nothing like what happened with her. Laisha was too. Well, Shay, you know how I felt about the way she was.
It was because she was black.
It was not. I let you marry Rachel, didn't I? The Packers are different. They raised Rachel right. I can tell them all I met her. I really could, dear. You're a fine girl. Don't pound out what you're thinking.
Well, thinking?
And Laisha?
Well, hun, she sounded...
ghetto?
Uneducated. I would never call anyone ghetto.
Laisha is a good person.
Well, you were blinded by your infatuation with her, sugar. But I saw her for who she is, and I could tell she had that victimized way of thinking. Like we owe her something.
And you owe Rachel an apology.
Oh, Sean, please, you're not stupid.
And you've got that way of thinking, Mom. Look, I didn't want to start an argument tonight. Let's just drop it.
I didn't realize what I say is such a big problem.
What you say is a problem. A lot of the time, Mom. You're making assumptions about Laisha, reporting that man last night. You made Rachel fried chicken for dinner and served watermelon for dessert.
This dinner wasn't supposed to be. Shay, I know what you think of me. I know you think I'm a racist.
I know you weren't, Mama.
I thought you would really like it. The watermelon. I'm not good at this. You both know I'm not good at this.
Couldn't you at least try to get better?
You don't understand. I know you don't understand, Shay. You're young. You've got a whole life to live. Now's the time for you kids to make mistakes, to learn new things, adapt to the world. It takes a long time to learn something, and even longer to unlearn it. And the older I get, the less time I have to start something over, the less I desire to even try. You know, dear, when Shay first
invited you over for dinner all those years ago, well, frankly, I was just shocked.
I know. 3 years ago, I wondered if you made the fried chicken for me as a joke or to make some sort of jab at me.
Would never do that.
I know. Instead, you go out of your way to make me happy. In a misunderstood sort of way, but you do try.
Such an understanding soul. Such a wonderful desire to love.
That's why I love her. She just has that way.
Hey, what's up, Steven?
Man.
Ready for the game this week?
Oh, yeah.
See, my man. You know you're cold, right? You know you're cold.
I didn't mean for it to come out that way. I was just
what? My mom is working
the lunch lady at our high school, and I quit the football team. There is no just anything.
You did quit the football team. Why didn't you quit? We needed you.
Fuck off.
Me fuck off? You're the one who should be told to fuck off. First you quit the team, and now this?
You don't understand.
Oh yeah?
You couldn't understand.
Try me.
All right. My mom, she's going through chemo. She got fired from one of her jobs. That's why she's working here as a lunch lady.
I'm sorry.
Oh, you're sorry? Huh. That's rich. Sorry that your mom doesn't work, that she's healthy.
She may not have to work, but...
Sorry that you don't have to work the night shift at 7-Eleven just to eat.
I may not have to work the night shift, but I...
Sorry that your dad is always there for you, and not God knows where, doing God knows what.
My dad isn't always there.
Oh, he's not at every football game. He doesn't come home every night after work.
Just because he's there doesn't mean he's present.
What in the hell?
He drinks. A lot. When he drinks, he yells. Sometimes he throws things, and they don't always hit the wall.
Oh, boo-hoo, man. You know, your dad drinks. My dad, he's even here. It's just me and my mom. And I intend to look out for her.
God damn it, Jackson. That's why you quit the football team? I'm your best friend, you couldn't even tell me?
Off of me. What are you doing?
Fine.
It's not any of your business!
My God.
You think you can just fix everything? Woo! Yeah, a little money will fix everything. Well, you can't. This is the real world. And we have to make choices. Clearly not something you're familiar with. Shit. Hey, a mess everywhere. What you done?
We can work through this.
No, we can't. This is over. I need to pay the rent today.
Why won't you just listen?
Maybe you didn't understand me the first time. I don't need to hear this horse shit from you. Huh? We're not the same. Not anymore.
How can you say that?
Maybe you haven't realized it, but I've grown up. I've had to make choices that affect my life. You. You, on the other hand, that's right, you didn't change at all. You self-absorbed quarterback with a false sense of righteousness. We're not the same. You don't know me.
What are you talking about? Doesn't matter. We could still put this behind us. It's not too late.
No, we can't.
It's not too late.
I've made my choice. I'm walking out that door. It's up to you now.
You're making a big mistake here. Jackson. I'm gonna tell! Jackson, stop! Damn it, Jackson!
Jen, what happened to us?
Under your shadow,
that's real life. You have no plans for this. No money saved. And what about Vinny?
What about him?
You promised him. He went out of his way to get you that special job on his crew.
Ma, it's a day labor job. I don't want to pour concrete. I want to paint.
Then paint houses. I'm sure Vinny...
No, Ma. It's not the same. I'm an artist.
You're not an artist. You're a kid.
I'm not a kid. I'm 17. I'll be 18 in 2 months. I won't need your permission then. I can do this without you.
Oh, you can you? And how the hell are you gonna pay for some fancy art school in England?
Scotland, Ma. Glasgow's in Scotland.
Whatever. Look at Sam. Okay. You think money grows on trees?
You always freaking say that. I'm not an idiot. I know it won't be easy.
Easy? It's impossible. You have no idea what this is going to cost. And for what? Some useless degree that won't even get you a real job. No life skills.
Art is my life. I have nothing without my art.
For crying out loud, you sound like your father.
I'm not like him.
Javier had his head in the clouds. I'm being real. You're being a dreamer.
You said that I could accomplish anything if I could just work hard enough.
And then finish high school. Going to a tech school. Become a dentist! Un dentista!
A dentist? Why the fuck?
Watch your mouth.
Why would I want to be a dentist?
I don't know. I just want you to get a good job so you don't have to work as hard as I do. I want more for you than this.
What about what I want? Does that even count?
Art is not a job. It's a hobby.
It's not a hobby, Mom.
It doesn't pay the bills either. I know.
Mom, I've been accepted into one of the best art schools in the world. That's a huge deal. I have to go. I am going.
No, you're not. It's not practical, and I'm not paying for it.
Dad, what is all this yelling about? You're loud enough to wake the dead.
I told her, Abuela. I showed her this letter.
Have you seen this?
Dear Marco, congratulations. I'm pleased to offer you admission to the Glasgow School of Art. Yes, of course, isn't it wonderful? Oh, thank you.
Wonderful! No. Did you know about this?
Well, who do you think paid the application fee?
Damn it, Mary! You had no right.
I had every right. He's my grandson.
That's me! You should have asked me first.
You just would have said no.
Damn right I would have. It's a waste of money. You're not going, and that's final.
Calm down. Let's talk.
How long have you been planning this?
A few months.
You've been planning this for a few months. This is the first I'm hearing about it.
Well, we decided. Mm-mm. I decided.
Worth the honesty. Fan-fucking-tastic.
You should be happy for him.
Happy? Oh, hell no. My son went behind my back to apply to a useless school, and you helped him.
It's not useless.
Is that your only problem with it?
Is that my only problem? No, I have a laundry list of problems.
Well, let's start with this. Look at what he can do.
I already know what he can do.
She don't care, Abuela. She never has. She hates that part of me.
That's not true.
It is! You hate that I'm even an ounce like my father.
No, that's not...
You haven't even seen my art. It makes you angry. That's why I have to hide it from you. Like this.
You don't understand.
either of you.
You think I don't understand? Javier was my son.
And you ruined him. You made him think that art was all he could do. That it wasn't good for anything else.
Now, wait a minute.
You made him miserable. You filled his head with pipe dreams. He died because of you.
Don't you dare lay that at my feet.
His overdose wasn't an accident. He felt like a failure.
Then it's because you made him feel that way. Always at him to get a real job.
We had to eat.
He wasn't there.
I worked 2 jobs.
You should have
stopped. I want more for the daydream.
Ah, stop it. Stop. I'm not my dad. You both keep making me into him. I'm not him. I'm not going to kill myself.
Like, these are Marco's?
They're good, aren't they?
They're amazing.
His work is so different than Javier's. Oh, you should see his paintings. Javier's was always seemed so chaotic, so
dark.
Look at the composition of this one.
His hand is so light, yet the strokes
strong,
confident.
Oh, and this one.
That's me. From 100 years ago, but that's me.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
But how?
I gave him an old picture of you and Javier. He came to me wanting to know about his dad, about what he was like, and about what you were like.
Me?
I couldn't talk about Javier without talking about you.
Oh, I'm sure that was a pleasant conversation.
Oh, it was. When Javier met you, you lit him up. I've never seen him smile so much. And you too, actually. You made each other happy.
That was a long time ago.
Was it? It seems like yesterday.
I'm scared, Mary.
I know.
I'm terrified, really.
I know.
What if I'm not there? What if he goes to this school and he, and I'm not there and he...
He's not Javier.
He's so much like him. His smile, the way he laughs, this.
He's not. You only see Javier, but I see you in him.
What's that gonna do?
Look, he's logical, he's practical, he thinks through everything. You were right. I let Javier dream. I took care of everything for him.
You were just being his mom.
He couldn't cope in the real world. But Marco can do both. Marco is different. He has something more, something that's uniquely Marco.
Determination.
He's a good kid. You did well with him.
We did well with him. Javier would want him to go.
Oh, he'd be so proud.
Ha! He'd be jealous.
So true. He never got an acceptance letter, let alone a scholarship. No. He barely made it through high school.
I didn't graduate.
and he'll be in a work program.
What?
To help pay expenses. The school's been very helpful.
He's really planned this out, hasn't he?
He's being practical. Who does that sound like?
Well, as everything.
I thought I had to referee a fight. There's not even any blood on the floor.
Come, sit with us. Tell me about your art school.